Hello everyone and welcome to another exciting episode of the One-on-One Show. Today I have a Nollywood darling. He's a hunk. Everyone loves him. He's a ladies' man. In fact, he lights up your screen. Who doesn't love Fredrick Leonard? How are you doing, Fredrick?
Don't make a black man blush. I'm good.
You're already white.
I'm good. How are you?
I'm great. So, your career in the Nollywood industry, everyone loves Fredrick. Everyone says, oh, he lights up my screen. I don't know if it's because he's light or is his acting that is lighting up your screen.
I tell you what it is, it's God's grace.
Okay. Just God's grace?
God's grace.
Talking about your career in acting, when exactly did you start? What date, what day?
Well, I think my first acting experience was in 2001. It was a short stint, you know. As a student, you want to experiment and with a few things and find your bearing, if I would have to call it that word.
Yeah.
You know, find where you fit in, and you know, I did a bit of all of that. Went back to school, studied biochemistry, came back in 2006, did a few things, got into modeling full time, blah blah blah. All that while I was developing myself physically and mentally, preparing myself for the job. So in 2010 I came in full time. So yeah.
Oh, two. So 2010.
Consistently. 2009 to 10, because I know I did Disclosure in 2009. A few people remember Indian Doctor in 2008, but I would say I took this business seriously and got myself totally involved.
In 2010 is when you took acting seriously and you have made a name for yourself. You know, a lot of people know you. This is just 4 years. How do you feel? Like, do you feel like yours is faster than other people's?
Well, like I said before, it's God's favor, really. And I would love to appreciate my fans who's been there for me over the years. I mean, they're the ones who get to watch all the movies. I would say almost all the movies that I make, the not so good ones and the very fantastic ones.
Now let's talk about your career. The Accident was one movie that I loved, directed by Teku Pensin. That movie with Chioma Akpota, everyone, you played, it was an amazing movie. How's the experience like working with Teku and, you know, producing that kind of movie, the movie that everyone loves, The Accident?
My goodness, The Accident is a movie close to my heart. I've gotten a lot of nominations for that movie. I've got 3 nominations this year, I won 2.
Woo!
1 for Cobra, shot, produced, and directed by Andy Boyo of Diamond Pictures, and then the other one, Accident.
Yeah.
Teku Pensin. Accident came at a time when I was hungry for a different kind of script.
Ooh, hunger.
You know what I mean? When I was hungry for something really, really fresh, you know, and I had spoken with Teku and he said, Fredrick, I'm going to send you something and I need you to look at it and tell me what you think. And then when he sent in the script, I looked at it and I could relate with the character Chike Dimuri.
Yeah.
The young man who wanted to divorce his wife because his wife was boring.
Okay, we must say that The Accident really did justice to your career. Now, talking about other movies, apart from The Accident, you're featured in other movies that are in the East, like Eastern movies.
Yeah,
then you're featured in the movies that they call Lagos movies, because, you know, the industry is kind of divided. Some people say they are from the East, while some are from Lagos. Which will you prefer? Will you say, I like to work in the East more than I like to work in Lagos? Do I prefer the Eastern movies or the Lagos movies?
My answer to that all the time is I like to work.
Oh, okay.
I like to film.
Yeah.
A movie project is a movie project. If the script is good, be it in the East, be it in the South, be it in the North, I'll do it.
Let's, during acting, you meet a lot of directors, producers, scriptwriters, actresses, you know, who are those particular set of people that you love to work with a lot? Is there any particular producer, director, or actor that you like to work with,
Actors. Actors, my colleagues, they all do a good job.
Mm-hmm. We're not talking about a good job, yeah.
They do a good
We're
job.
Talking about people.
How can you really tell? We all have, we're different in our own ways,
yeah.
But we also try to coexist as colleagues, you know, and do a good job at the end of the day. For me, a good director is, in my opinion, is someone who is well-rounded. I've been able to work with a few of them, and I'm glad I did, because for every time you work with such directors.
You want to mention a few?
Don't ask me, but that's never going to happen. Every time you work with such people, you take something from them.
Okay.
All right, I tell you this, baby. Mm-hmm. At some point in my career, I would love, look at it this way.
Yeah.
I would love to contribute to the growth of an industry that has blessed me.
Okay. So you want to be a philanthropist?
How best can I do that?
Oh, okay.
Probably coming as a producer at some point.
Oh, okay.
Contribute to the quality of movies we make.
Okay.
Employ people.
Oh, okay.
It's part of my give back.
To the society. Okay.
Plan.
Yes. That's all.
Have I answered you?
You've tried maybe 50 out of 100. Now, in your acting career, there's a height that you want to attain and say, yes, I am there.
Yes.
What is that height? Like, what is it that you would have done that will make you feel like I have done it all? Like, I have fulfilled my career. I have fulfilled myself as a human being.
I would say Oscars.
Oh, Oscars.
All right. Now, but having said that, I think what would be most fulfilling is when I stand on the street and somebody walks up to me and say, I stopped being a drug addict.
Ooh.
Because of you. Because you played a drug addict in a movie, and then I could see the aftermath of that kind of lifestyle.
Yeah.
I dropped a lot of negative vices that I got myself entangled with because of you.
Okay, there are a lot of young people that are watching, a lot of young actors that are like, my role model is Fredrick Leonard. What is the secret, and what do you think the steps they should take to become someone like you or even close to you?
First off, I don't think they can be like me.
Close.
First off, they will be what God has ordained them to be.
Probably
greater than I am. I'm just telling you the truth.
Okay.
Probably greater than I am. I will come to your bar, your house, to shoot a movie, or come to the airport. Please allow us to do it so we can do it well, so that you don't sit back and say, why they use that kind of bedroom shoots? They don't say this is no fine. Probably I walked up to you and you said, no, sir, I can't use your bedroom. I can't use your hotel. So we need support, not monetary. Just have an open mind and believe in what we do. That way we can all grow together.
But we want to thank you so much from Village Square TV for coming on the show. And we had an amazing time. I don't know if it's only me, but I had a great time.
I had a wonderful time too.
Yeah.
Thanks for having me.
All right.
I'd love to do this with you guys again.
Okay, again and again and again and again. We have finally come to the end of this wonderful episode of the One-on-One Show with Fredrick Leonard. In fact, I had so much fun on set. I learned so much from him, some secrets to success, his religious life, the fact that he's hardworking, and so many things. It is good to have someone like that on the show. This is the One-on-One Show on Village Square TV. My name is Hawa. Remember, the stories live here.